Joining us now is Christopher Pyne and Anthony Albanese. Good morning to you both. Christopher,
Good morning, $10 billion.
It's a lot of money in 7 months. Anyone would think that maybe the PM is trying to buy some votes.
Well, firstly, happy birthday for tomorrow, because I won't see you tomorrow.
That's a nice way to start. Yeah.
That story is an unusual kind of story, because they've extrapolated out decisions that have been made and pushed them out a couple of years and said that looks like how much money will be spent. For example, in my portfolio of innovation, they've said that it's a $1.7 billion commitment, when the announcement was actually $1.1 billion, but they've just kept extrapolating it out beyond the forward estimate.
But it still flies in the face of what Scott Morrison is promising, of spending less and saving more. How is he going to do it?
We'll certainly spend a lot less than the Labor Party, because they're promising $100 billion of new taxes, $100 billion of new spending, and more borrowing if they haven't got the money.
It's your budget on May 3.
It'll be good.
How is Scott Morrison going to balance the books when his PM keeps spending?
Well, we are going to come back to surplus over a sensible period of time. We'll certainly get back to surplus. Last surplus Labor delivered was 1989, and they'll never deliver a surplus if they get elected.
What is the period of time?
Well, we're not going to put a handbrake on the economy. We're not going to slam the handbrakes on us by just stopping government spending. We will have a measured track back to surplus, and you'll see that in the budget in a couple of weeks' time. But under Labor, $100 billion of new taxes over 10 years, all apparently going to be spent. A tax and spend election from Labor versus, you know, living within our means, and Malcolm Turnbull versus Bill Shorten on the election day.
All right, now, of course, we're off and running. A 74-day, very long, very crucial election campaign, Anthony. It was a perhaps slow start out of the blocks for Bill Shorten here on Tuesday morning when asked about his time as finance minister, and he went on to say that any government should only have one royal commission in it. Do you agree with that? There's only one royal commission in each government?
Well, I'll tell you what we won't be doing is having royal commissions into the current government like they've done. I think if you look at what we did in office, where Julia Gillard made the courageous decision to have the royal commission into abuse by our institutions of young people, that has had an impact on people's lives. In a very different way, I think the Banking Royal Commission that we've announced will have an impact on people. There's so many families watching this show right now who've been impacted by bad advice from banks or financial institutions. We need to get to the bottom of it.
I think you both agree on that the banks need to be more accountable. But why didn't Labor introduce a Royal Commission when you had the chance? Bill Shorten couldn't answer that on Tuesday.
Well, what we've seen, Sylvia, in the last 3 years, while the coalition's been in government, is issue after issue come up with the banks and financial institutions, so that it's moved beyond there being an issue with one particular institution. It now looks as though the sector has a problem. It has a cultural problem. And we've seen that acknowledged by the extraordinary response this week, where the banks have agreed to pay more money, $120 million, to ensure that they're made to be accountable in terms of the government. Now, if you can get that sort of response straight away from the announcement of a Royal Commission, then imagine what response in terms of better services for consumers you'll get from an actual Royal Commission.
But the fact is, you had the chance to do it when you had government, when you were
in power.
Bill Shorten accepted when he was here on Tuesday that the problems go back as far as the Labor government.
But you have, of course there are issues when we're in government, but what you have in order to have a case for a Royal Commission is you've got to have systemic issues. And what's clear is that you do have systemic issues, and you have to go back to the previous
point.
I noticed that Christopher acknowledged before that all our promises were paid for. A key concession
yesterday, Bill Shorten said that he had a little list of things that he'd like for the Royal Commission. It's completely blown up in his face, because he'd put no thinking in it. He just wanted to take banks and royal commissions in the same sentence, but actually had no plans
responded to it this week, Christopher.
Well, we fixed it. Albo, what are you doing with the truckies?
We have a view that there's a relationship between the rates at which people are paid in terms of safe rates.
Are you going to bring back the bill?
And accidents. What we will do is have a response in terms of safe rates, making sure that our roads are kept safe, by consulting not just with the unions but with the Australian Trucking Association, the Livestock Transporters Association. That's what we did when we were in government.
So you will
bring back
the bill?
That is what we will do. We will have a response in terms of safety on our roads because there is that direct link there. 330 people died last year in accidents involving heavy vehicles.
I want to play some audio that came through earlier in the week from a spokesperson from the Transport Workers Union. Let's have a listen to that.
We've had a commitment from the Labor Party. We need legislation to assist that. And we had the legislation. The Labor Party has committed, if they win government, they will bring back legislation.
So that sounds like a pretty firm commitment from you.
Well, we will have legislation of some sort. We will take action. We will take action in terms
of... Have you made a promise to the union?
We have made a promise that we're committed to safety on our roads, absolutely.
All right, we've got to leave it there for now. Unfortunately, we have run out of time. But, gentlemen,
thanks,
thank
Sylvia.
You so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you.
Happy birthday tomorrow.
Thank you so much. It will be a wonderful day. I will miss both of your company.
I left it to the end so I didn't get, you know,
I know. Well, you know, it's good to score points early, Anthony. Just to bear that in mind later.
I don't remember when you turned 30, Anthony.
We don't have time for memory lane, Carl.
It was. It was indeed.
I have a feeling it still would have been a decent party. Albo's party.